Welcome to the Worshipful Company of Wheelwrights. Here in the Great Hall of the Guildhall in the Civic Centre of London, we are remembering the 350th anniversary of our Worshipful Company this year. Our company is all about maintaining mobility and the idea of the wheel, which of course has been the centre of mobility for over 6,000 years. Our aim is to ensure that in developing fellowship, philanthropy and charitable endeavours, we can deliver something that will be beneficial to people who are in need and deserve that mobility. Here, above me, is the crest of our Worshipful Company, and the centre of which is the wheel. That wheel provides the unity with which we are all familiar. If we are to do our job, we aim to ensure that people have the chance to gain mobility again and to move forward. This film, hopefully, will show you a bit more about what we do on a day-to-day basis and in various aims. And if you'd like to know more about our company, then please look at the website at the end of the film. Thank you.
In the City of London, there is a group of men and women who are dedicated to wheels. Coach wheels. Chinese wheels. Chariot wheels. They're extremely fond of their wheels and go to great lengths to care for them.
We have a restored, repaired costermonger's wheel. This has got a brand new felis, two new spokes and a brand new tyre.
Ah, the wheelwright. Morning, how are you?
Very well, thank you.
Very good.
In 1670, the wheel makers of London came here to Guildhall to be incorporated into the City of London as the Worshipful Company of Wheelwrights. Charles II granted the Wheelwrights a royal charter, and this year, in 2020, they're celebrating their 350th anniversary. Wheels have been around for thousands of years. The Egyptians, the Greeks, the Romans all had them. The ancient Britons, too, understood the importance of mobility. On today's busy streets, the movement of people and traffic is what makes a city work. That's why, as a charity, supporting mobility for the disabled is their key concern. Whether that's a small charity or a national organisation such as Riding for the Disabled. Through their partnerships, they work with disabled ex-servicemen and women, helping them into sports and active lives. But keeping the craft of wheelmaking alive is at the centre of what they do. Douglas Andrews is a wheelwright. He's been making wheels for 30 years. A year ago, he was able to take on Tom Carroll as an apprentice. With support from the Wheelwrights charity and the Coachmakers and Coach Harness Makers charity.
The funding that they put together to basically help cover my time in teaching Tom the trade of wheelwrighting, that bridges the gap between making it a viable opportunity and a viable situation for me, because in the harsh realities of the world, you know, I have to, you know, as being a one-man band, I have to stop work to teach Tom what to do, and all the bills are still going out.
Oh, Tom. Nice to meet you, Tom.
Today, James Tucker, the master of the Worshipful Company of Wheelwrights, is meeting Tom to present him with an award.
I have for you a cheque for £1,200 from the Wheelwrights charity. Can you tell me what you plan to do with the money?
Well, I plan to buy some tools during my apprenticeship that hopefully will last me a lifetime.
And several weeks later, Tom was able to buy a wonderful set of tools.
So this is a number 10 remake plane. I managed to acquire it in a local auction. You know, put a bid in.
Wheels, of course, are about mobility. and mobility is vital for a disabled adult or child. For over 3 years, the Wheelwrights have been supporting Wheel Power, a wonderful charity that organises the Interspinal Games based here at Stoke Mandeville, home of the Paralympic movement.
And I just want to show people what I can actually do, just because I'm in my walker or something. I want to show them what I'm capable of.
My medal is for taking part. I did lots of things, like table tennis, swimming, archery.
The Worshipful company of Wheelwrights, through the Wheelwrights charity, have done absolutely brilliantly in raising so much money for Wheel Power and for what we do with paralysed people. They've raised over £60,000 so far since 2016, and given that through the 2020 fund. And it's absolutely vital because the Interspine Unit Games is 100% charitably funded.
Chris Keogh was injured while playing football with his mates. Becoming involved with the games at Stoke Mandeville has been a transformative experience.
You know, the moment I arrived, I met my teammates, and it sort of felt like being back in the changing rooms and the banter. You know, we all sort of know each other, a few of us. We got on immediately. For those that we didn't know, we head straight out to the local pub and had a meal, had some drinks. It was really, really good fun. I tried sports that I never thought I would ever be able to play. You know, fencing, for instance, I didn't even know that was an option for wheelchair users. Even boccia was great fun. Archery, rugby. Quite good at table tennis before the games, but I managed to win a gold medal or to come first in the Tetra table tennis competition. So maybe I'm better than I think I was.
As part of their tradition as a livery company in the City of London, every year the Wheelwrights have an annual dinner here at the Mansion House. This year they're honouring Martin Colclough, who's been the driving force behind Help for Heroes.
I give you this certificate of your freedom.
I work for Help for Heroes, and I'm an ex-officer as well. And in 1995, the Wheelwrights came to the rehabilitation centre at Headley Court, wanting to offer some support to critically injured servicemen and women to help them get back into sport. And over the past 10 years or so, we've now been working together to try and achieve that with considerable success.
The Wheelwrights have had a long association with the armed services, and in particular, the King's Troop Royal Horse Artillery.
So this is the 13-pounder guns that we have in the King's Troop. We have 9 of them in service. Most of the guns that we have still here today saw action in the First World War, and they still have the original barrels and some of the components that was in today.
One of the most vital components of this gun are its huge wheels, which have to be extremely tough. The wheels are made here in the workshop of Crowford Coach Builders in Kent.
We do all sorts of jobs. Anything that is a wooden wheel, we are interested in doing. So we do veteran car wheels. We made new wheels for the Lord Mayor's coach. We do a lot of work for the Royal Mews. We also do the wheels for the King's Troop, who give the salutes for the Queen.
Add it to the pile. Happy with that? Very nice. Looking good.
This one's come in. It's got to the end of its life. The wheels itself are constructed with very heavy oak spokes to take the shock of running. If you can imagine, originally, when these wheels were first built and were used in the field, the whole gun carriages would sometimes go over the top of fallen trees and logs and boulders and things and would jump all over the place. So they need to be very, very strong. On the front here, you'll note, there's a locking plate. If you can see here, the plate is actually cracked through vibration when the wheel is in use. This will have to be replaced. They have probably some of the hardest working wheels that we actually get in and work on.
Today, Edward Crouch is in central London on a visit to check a very special set of wheels that his company has made.
As we made new wheels, I'm particularly concerned to make sure they're absolutely perfect, which they are. There's no movement whatsoever. No, there's no movement there at all. Looks very good. A lot of the demand for wooden wheels is connected to the country's major industry, which is tourism. And it is so important that these carriages are able to go out, that people see horse-drawn buses, they see the coaches, and these things really do boost Britain's tourism.
Every summer, the British Driving Society holds an event in Great Windsor Park. Here, you'll see some outstanding examples of driving teams. The Wheelwrights sponsor a class for the best vintage vehicle.
Well done.
Yes, I'm delighted to win this award and this cup. And it's lovely that the Wheelwrights company appreciate the old antique horse carriages.
In the small village of Colliton in Devon, the Rowland family have been wheelwrights in this area for hundreds of years.
So this is a Cornish farm wagon. Farm wagons are really popular, certainly in this area as well. But this has had a complete restoration, any repairs needed, and then a repaint. Our sign writer has done some lovely work on the sides, and she's done a lovely sign for the farrier to go on the back as well, which is like an advertisement for him in the show ring. So that one will sit right there.
Greg has just taken delivery of a very unusual project, an Edwardian horse ambulance. It's a big project, but nothing seems to daunt Greg's enthusiasm.
Well, that's different. Well, it needs some work. That's quite a rare-looking thing. I don't think I've seen one like this before. Obviously, it had a canvas roof, which is missing. You have to get into the head of who made it. You have to get yourself back to how it was done then, and then you start thinking about how to do it. I'm not sure how it works yet. I need a good look. Yeah, so all of this cage would come backwards out of the vehicle. What a fascinating thing. And yeah, they can winch the horse in whichever way, because they've probably just shot it. That's what it's, you know, that's what it is. This is my first glimpse of this one, and as projects go, this one looks pretty interesting. I think you get some that grip you right from the start, and some that you just do because you can. This is interesting. I like the look of this.
Recently, the Wheelwrights have linked up with the National Tyre Distributors Association. This partnership has meant an increase in funds for the charity and more people becoming involved with the company.
Well, industry colleagues, distinguished guests, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to the 90th NTDA annual dinner.
And tonight, they're sponsoring an award for the Apprentice Tyre Technician of the Year.
And the winner is Ryan Park.
I knew I had a good chance of getting it, but didn't think it'd actually happen, so I'm well and truly off the moon with it. So, yeah, I'm very pleased, yeah, and I'm glad that all the hard work's paid off.
I've worked really hard for it, yeah. My work ethic's always been absolutely non-stop. Always try and keep myself busy, try and learn as much as I can, whenever I can. Just give everything me 100% effort, really, yeah.
As part of their ongoing support for Wheel Power, the company held a music festival here in Holy Trinity Church in London. Over the last 10 years, the Worshipful Company of Wheelwrights has supported over 200 charities and individuals and raised thousands of pounds in sponsorship.
Well, this
Sponsorship of the Wheelwrights is just essential. RDA is celebrating its 50th year this year, and carriage driving is an enormous part of that.
Extremely important. Without the sponsorship, obviously the games wouldn't happen, and we wouldn't be able to reap all the benefits at the games and following the games.
Without the Worshipful company Wheelwrights' support, I wouldn't have an apprenticeship, and I'm very grateful for their support.
Thank you.